All right, Jimmy. All right, ready when you are. One of our main goals with building this robot was to make it as simple and inexpensive as possible. So we used a lot of cardboard, for example. We also borrowed a lot of components so that we wouldn't have to buy them. One of the things that we borrowed that ended up being very beneficial for our robot was the gearing system that provided the amount of torque we needed to turn the agitator in our hopper. Thanks, guys in the EE shop. Another inexpensive feature of our robot that we decided to implement was the ping pong ball nubs on the bottom of our acrylic base. We decided to go with this option so we could save money from having to buy bearings, and we wanted to keep with the ping pong theme.
So for a shooting mechanism, what we did was we had a hopper and wheels attached to DC motors. It was like a baseball pitching machine thrown it down a tube. And what we did was we designed a little ramp to where we could attach PVC pipe and the two motor mechanisms. And they all laid in the same plane, so as adjustments needed to be made, the motors would be adjusted together along with the angle of the barrel. And it would be fed by a hopper. Originally, we chose to do a milk jug, but then we found that the balls would get stuck as they were going through the hole. And that coupled with the amount of space that we realized we had, we just decided to make it as big as we possibly could.
So with the brackets, we were originally thinking that we were going to 3D print them. That turned out to be an impractical solution because we needed them to be adjustable. We were still in the process of designing the shooter and everything that needed to go underneath our hopper. We ended up using metal sheets that were adjustable, that were strong, and they were able to support our hopper. And an extra bonus that we were not expecting, that it looked like Smalls Erector from Sandlot.
One of the main features that differentiates our robot from others was the agitator in the hopper. We realized that we needed some sort of an agitator or some sort of a paddle wheel to prevent the balls from jamming when they were emptying the hopper into our shooter. And so we designed this wonderful CAD model here that you see now. And it turned out to be very successful in helping the balls to load into the shooter more consistently and keeping the hopper from jamming.
Well, we actually just tried to keep it simple, just like the rest of the robot. So we ended up using only one interrupt through the whole thing. That just went into a set of if statements that was just based on a counter through a timer. And that made it really simple. The logic was really simple. It just followed very easily. We just basically used copy and paste to have it go back to the dispenser to get more. But it did kind of make a little bit of, or cause a little bit of a problem for us when we needed to go back and change something earlier on in our if statements, because then we'd have to go back and do menial math to through the rest of the counter numbers to make sure that it was consistent and changed along with that. So.
Looking back on it, there are a few things that we wish we could have done differently. One of the things was we wanted to have bigger wheels. Our original thought was we wanted it low to the ground, have as much space for the hopper. But we wish we could have made it a little bit faster, a little bit higher off the ground, avoiding the ping pongs that did not go into the ball goal. We also wish we would have planned out the wiring a little bit more and a few other things just to make it look a little bit neater, a little bit tidier.
So one of the other problems we ran into with our code was the watchdog timer interrupt. We found out that, unfortunately, during the competition, that if we didn't disable the interrupt, it would start over, rather, our code, which was a problem, so we had to disable that interrupt.